Hello, my name is Tony Pike, and I am the founder of CAT3C. CAT3C is designed to provide supplemental training as you work your way through your ATPL studies. We're doing this with a series of live online training sessions which allow you the opportunity to interact with a real instructor without leaving the comfort of your own home. Just think, no more traffic jams, expensive train journeys, overpriced accommodation, delayed flights or uncomfortable channel crossings. Just turn on your computer and log into our sessions on the date and time of the course from anywhere with an internet connection. Added to these sessions are the question explanation videos, or QEVs. Each QEV refers to an actual EASA Part FCL ATPL examination question, which the instructor will explain, taking you through each step of the solution. More information on our online sessions and our three-day UK-based classroom training courses can be found at our website, www.cat3c.com. But for now, sit back and enjoy this QEV. An aircraft is maintaining a compass heading of 124 degrees compass. Compass deviation equals minus 3 degrees and magnetic variation equals 4 degrees west. What is the true heading being flown? A, 125 degrees true, B, 123 degrees true, C, 117 degrees true, or D, 131 degrees true. When trying to find a true heading from a compass heading, the first thing we need to do is to write down the mnemonic Cadbury's Dairy Milk Very Tasty. C, D, M, V, T. That's compass, deviation, magnetic, variation, true. The next thing is to fill in the blanks, fill in the information that we know beneath each letter. So the compass heading is 124 degrees compass. Put a separator line in there. Deviation we know is minus 3 degrees. Magnetic heading we need to calculate. Variation we know is 4 degrees west. And the true heading we need to calculate as well. Now, in order to get to the true heading from the compass heading, we have to go via magnetic. And the simplest way to do that is to identify the direction of the deviation or variation. A negative deviation, as you may remember, is westerly. In which direction is west? It's to the left. So we place an arrow pointing to the left. Again, with variation, is westerly. So we place another arrow pointing to the left. Now, in order to go from compass to magnetic via deviation, we simply identify the direction of the arrow. The arrow's pointing to the left. That means out of compass and magnetic, the arrow always points to the larger number, and therefore compass will be greater than magnetic by the deviation. So 124 minus 3 is 121 magnetic. Repeat the process to go from magnetic to true. The arrow points to the left, it's pointing to the larger number, which is magnetic. So true will be less than magnetic by 4 degrees. 121 minus 4 is 117 degrees true. So our final answer is 117 degrees true, option C.